Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Josh Taylor, and today I'll be teaching you how to change a light bulb. So the overall goal is to just learn the best method to doing it, and also the best ways to stay safe, and also save the most money. Because there's a lot of bulbs out there that really don't fit in certain situations, and you just end up burning too much electricity and get way too big of an electrical bill. But there's definitely some more economically sound solutions out there. So before you do anything, you definitely want to test the oval, make sure it's definitely not working anymore. You can do this by flipping the switch a few times, and also just making sure it's screwed in right. But typically you don't want to touch it too much, because if it's burnt out, it's probably pretty hot. But yeah, just flip it a few times, make sure it doesn't come back on at all. So if you're getting a new bulb, just make sure it's the right size, so it'll fit the same socket. You can often just take the old bulb with you whenever you go shopping for a new one. There's not really much variety in your common house situations. But also, you have to make sure it's an economically sound one. There's a lot of, I guess I'm trying to say, you don't want a bulb that would go in like a floodlight in your closet, because then you just blind yourself while you're trying to get dressed in the morning. But yeah, typically the best ones are those ones that are sort of shaped like a coil. I don't know if you guys have ever seen one like that, but they're the most efficient ones and they last the longest, so those are definitely the ones you want to go for. So when you're replacing the bulb, if it's up high somewhere, you want to get a stepladder of some kind. Or if you're just on like a little lamp, you can just do it around your desk. Make sure it's off first. You probably won't shock yourself to death changing a light bulb, but again, it can get pretty hot and you don't want to burn yourself. Also, if you're on like a lighting fixture that has like a cover on it, you definitely want to remove that first. Most of the time you can just twist it off, but they come in all shapes and sizes, but I'm sure you can figure it out, it's not that hard. So just basically unscrew the old bulb, make sure it's cool, and then screw in the new one. The most danger from this doesn't come from getting shocked at all, it's mostly because the bulb is kind of fragile. So if you twist it too hard, you might break it and cut yourself. So that's definitely the biggest danger, I guess you could say. But when you're testing the new bulb, make sure it's screwed in right. And make sure you don't put too much pressure on it again, or because you might break it. And then just test the light switch, flick it on and off a few times, and it should work as intended. So in summary, first you should make sure the bulb's not working. Then when you're buying a new one, make sure you get the right one. And when you're handling them, be gentle with them and as careful as you can. And you should have all the light you need.